incredible games too.
They were.
That included, or that made it even better. So.
Tip comes off. Atlanta Black tips it to Allie Mon. They have been fun to watch throughout the years.
There's some athletes, boys and girls, that seem like they played for 15 years.
I know.
And there's some of them on both of these teams here tonight. So. But they have. They're tremendous athletes.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, Clint, this is the toughest place to be in this third, fourth game. You were so close to playing in the championship game last night, and your dreams and hopes were dashed. And third place is nothing to shake a stick at.
No.
It's just not what you dream of. You don't dream of going to state and taking third.
Well, and Panguitch is used to playing in that state championship game. I think they've won the last three.
They
so
have.
Most of these girls here, they kind of knew it was bittersweet for them. But I looked at them as they come on the floor, and you could see disappointment still on their faces on both sides. But I'm sure once things get rolling here, they'll just fall into place.
Yeah. No, and the Bobcats came out of Region 20, number four. It's Shante Miller with the take, and Black with the rebound ahead to Adair. Mon to Reeve. Adair. Getting set up for that championship game coming up at 5 o'clock. Both these schools that play in the championship game today, I'll bet there's not many people left in Tabiona or Tropic, Bryce Valley area.
It's a big deal for sure for anybody to make it. So there's a lot of excitement on social media and all the way around on both sides. So should be a good one. You know, Panguitch, for the most part here, Mike, same as last night, they're willing to just pack it down in. If you can shoot it, go ahead, but they're not giving much in the middle.
And that ball rimmed out. Mon looked good for a second. Torgerson. Torgerson must have started for Henry. I didn't notice that. Orton,
no.
Deep two.
Yeah, she did. And I don't, did she even play last night, the Torgerson girl, much at all?
A little, not a ton. Hmm. And there, Henry's getting ready to check in. Mon looked like she hadn't established herself inbounds, takes that pass away, brings it up and lays it in.
Nice move.
I talked to Ali Mon's dad last night a couple times at dinner, and then I ran into him in the store. He coached Monticello basketball for 17 years, I think he told me.
Wow.
He said it was tough, the loss last night for these girls. Bert Bennett with the putback and a foul on Orton.
I have decided that there's a place in heaven for girls basketball coaches.
Yeah. I was watching during the Wayne County game. Brinley Nelson from Wayne County fouled out, and she's a sophomore, and they were ahead. She fouled out early in the fourth quarter, and you could tell her, I mean, they were having fun, but she was frustrated, went down, sat at the end of the bench, and Coach Ellett he goes down and kind of sits down next to her and leans on her a little bit. Mm-hmm. And you just kind of, and before long, she's smiling and he's smiling. And there's a lot of psychology.
Oh, yes.
Miller on the break.
Nice basket by Shantae Miller. It takes a little more, I don't know if love's the right word, and finesse, but it's opened my eyes this year for sure. So these girls work hard. They put a lot, they put everything into it.
Yeah, they do.
Try to go over the top with that one. Shantae Miller gets a hand on it, but goes out on Monticello.
They put a lot of time into it for sure. I got confirmation between games. We've been doing the interviews at halftime of the seniors of the previous game. And both Rich and Tintic, their senior, said that they'd come up and visit with me in the studio. So we'll have interviews with them at the halftime. So those of you still watching from those areas.
That's a neat thing.
I wish there was more time to kind of get to know them a little more, because we know them as basketball players.
Right.
There's so much more to it than that.
It opened my eyes last year. It's a neat thing that you do that, because you're right. You know, when you hear all the boys, especially last year, because I remember because I had a boy, but just to hear their life goals and what's going to happen, it's pretty neat. These kids, some extremely sharp kids.
Yeah. Jordan Bennett hits the deep two from the corner. That's last night. We interviewed Okwale from St. Joe and the Tolman girl. And Okwale is going to Grand Canyon University pre-med.
Wow.
And I'm like,
that's awesome.
It's pretty neat.
Yep. Birch was fouled up top here. The Panguitch ball. So pretty hard defense here, Mike, to start out. Not a lot of offense.
No, that's I expect, you know, these two teams last night, the Bobcats scored 24 and Monticello scored 29. So
it's going to be pretty defensive for sure. But you would expect that on the last day of the state tournament.
Yeah, legs get tired.
Yep.
Legs get tired. It's been a lot of basketball. Panguitch, this is their fifth consecutive night, their eighth game in 11 days.
Wow. Yep. Hard games, too.
A lot of contact from Miller on Black.
Just the ball out of bounds. Wow.
Taken away by Adair, back to Black.
Sounds like an AC/DC song, Mike.
Yeah, back to Black. And missed by Slade.
Henry comes out with the rebound.
Here, Dave, you're muted. Did you know? Oh, okay.
Henry for three, just off the front.
And a rebound foul on the Bobcats. Bert Bennett. I apologize if I call a girl by their wrong name. I've called a lot of girls' names in the last 5 days.
You guys have done a good job. I wasn't able to make it the first day, and I'll tell you, you're our lifeline. So I commend all of you.
You're in bad shape if David and I are your lifeline.
Well, I'll tell you what, I think I'd put my life in your guys' hands. Maybe not David on an everyday deal, but...
Foul on that on Taylor or on Jordan Bennett. Don't know, Shantae Miller with her first. Still 4-2. That's a low scoring quarter. Black has the ball stripped by Birch, gets it back and in. Ties it up. Has the ball stripped away by Adair. Air into the game for the Bobcats. Birch. Go ahead.
Yeah, Birch takes it away, but almost stolen back from Monticello, and Henry ends up with it.
Birch has been, she has played so well in this tournament. She has, you know, not always scored a ton of points, but 8 to 10 a night, I think, and just she's everywhere.
She's the engine for the Bobcats. There's no doubt about that.
You know, she's not a lot of seniors on the, there's 3 seniors on the Bobcats.
She's one of them that we talk about that's been here for a long time.
That's right. So, hey, you're watching Utah High School Sportscast. That's going to do it for the first quarter, 4-4 tie. We'll be back.
Something hidden. Go and find it. Something lost behind the ranges, lost and waiting for you. Go. I remember lighting fires. I remember sitting by them. I remember seeing faces, hearing voices while I climb. Very full of dreams, that desert. But my 2 legs took me through it. Something lost behind the ranges. Now go and take your time.
Bryce Canyon Half Marathon. 13.1 miles of fast and unforgettable running on scenic Byway 12. From Bryce Canyon City descending to Cannonville through the majestic Bryce Canyon National Park. Race runs on the second Saturday in July. Start training today. Register at BryceCanyonHalfMarathon.com.
All right, welcome back for the second quarter. Monticello got the tip, so it'll be Panguitch Bobcat basketball in a 4-4 tie. We have seen some defensive battles. Even that first day, Panguitch and Duchesne, the Bobcats held Duchesne to 15 points. You know, there's just been some real defensive battles.
So the foul's on Slade, sending Birch to the line for 2. Got the first. Their second, good as well.
Pass into Black, dribbles past the defenders, and fouled.
She just was going, regardless. She was going in there. Tough play.
Yeah, she plays. You know, it's interesting. You look out there, and the floor is deceiving. It's all about perspective and size. I mean, you look out there, and you think, Atlanta Black, she's a big player, and she's not.
Right.
They're staying at the same hotel we are, and she's not real big.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, we had this conversation coming up that, you know, you look at some of these and you're like, man, we can't match up with them until you get on the floor with you. And you're like, man, they're the same size as us.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you're right.
And it's been neat this year. You know, the state tournament, there's a lot of parity. I felt like coming in there was 8 teams that could, on any given day, beat any one of the other 8 to 10 teams that were at the top. And it's really kind of played out that way.
Yeah. I ran into a couple guys from Paiute yesterday, talking to them, and they said, you know, had Paiute or Wayne County showed up and played like they did yesterday, there wasn't a team here that could have beat them yesterday.
You
know, and it goes back to what you're saying. There's 8 teams that was any of them. I mean, could have really.
And on any night.
Yep. And some of them went home early.
Yes, they did.
Which is crazy.
Atlanta Black, cross court to Mond. Bounce pass in to Slade, up, blocked from behind, put back up and in by Timber Black. Timber Black comes off the bench and gives the Bucks a great boost. She's averaging 4 to 6 points in each game, the last couple games off the bench for the Bucks. And in games that last night she had 7, in a 24-to-30-point game, that's a lot
that's
of points.
Big, absolutely. Now, are they all sisters, cousins? How is it?
I'm not sure.
There's three, right?
There's three, and they've got to be cousins somehow. But
that's kind of like saying Brinkerhoffs aren't all cousins in Bryce Valley, huh?
Yeah, kind of like that. Or Spencer's in Valley.
Right, yep.
Lamborn's in Rich.
You know what? That's why we love this. That's why 1A basketball is so much fun.
Bounce pass in. Taken away by Slade. She gives to Atlanta Black. Hesitates. Pulls up in the paint. No good. Rebound.
Abby Blevins.
Yep.
Coach Barney's subbing early tonight, Mike.
These girls
seen some time. They didn't see much last night. I believe that was Orton with the miss. Rebound by Monticello.
Cross court, lob inside to Reeve, and she's fouled by Blevins. You know, and that's really smart from Coach Barney. He has three seniors on the team, Shantae Miller, Jaylee Torgerson, and Brianna Birch, and that might be why Jaylee Torgerson started tonight.
Yeah.
As a senior.
That's great.
Give the seniors their time, but also, you know, you can't replace time for Abby Blevins any other way.
Hey, that's your team right there next year for sure, so absolutely. Makes them both. So Monticello's stretched it out a little here, Mike, up 4 points. The offense has picked up a little bit in the second quarter here.
Yeah, we've 2.5 minutes into the second. We've doubled the scores in the, you know, it was 4-4 for 8 points in the first quarter, and we have 16 now. So.
Fouls on Atlanta Black.
Timber Black, number 3. I think he's worked up. What do you think?
I hope he didn't have his monster energy because I don't think he needs it today.
Coach Brinkerhoff from Bryce Valley up here harassing us. Ball loose, picked up by Timber Black.
Barney into the game for the Bobcats.
Little floater up, no good. Rebound. Barney.
Ooh.
Orton planted that first foot and then drug her back foot. Coach Barney saying, just a jump stop.
Yep.
Just give me a jump stop. Pass inside, taken away by Matea Barney. They had Slade double teamed.
Birch tries to go into Blevins just over her head, be out of bounds for Monticello.
I'll tell you, Clint, I don't know how many girls are in Monticello High School.
A lot.
There's 17 cheerleaders right there, and 14 girls on the basketball team.
You look at some of them cheerleaders, too. They're tall enough. I bet they'd probably be ball players as well. Into the ball game for Panguitch. McCall Tebbs replaces Birch. So Coach Barney saying, all right, let's see what you guys got it. Giving these guys a chance, so.
Cross court.
Blevins gets a hand on it, gets a steal. Out front to Orton. Back to Barney. Just off the rim. Rebound Orton. Back up. She's fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Fouls on 21. Allie Mon, is that right?
Mon, yep.
That's Mon's third foul. That's a big foul for the Bucks. That brings in Esplin, number five, Tristan Esplin. And Slade checks back in for Megan Black.
Got the second one there for Orton.
Shot blocked. Reeves' shot partially blocked. Blevins with the rebound. Outlet pass ahead to Tebbs. Something about that name's familiar. I just can't place it, but something's familiar. David's niece out there on the floor. Henry, bounce pass into Matea Barney. Matea, just a freshman. She's going to be a tough ball player as she comes along in the Bobcat program. Coach Clint Barney's daughter.
She don't have a choice.
Yeah. Ah, there's always a choice.
There's a choice.
Maybe.
You can see it, though. She's hard-nosed right now. She is going to be tough.
Tebbs, 18-footer, no good. Rebound pulled down by Slade.
So the Bobcats only have one junior. So this is a pretty young bunch, really, besides the three seniors they have. So they're gonna be around for a while as well. So
Matea Barney jumps in, ties it up.
You know, they talk about court time and minutes on the floor and state tournament games. I wonder if that's part of Coach Barney's strategy here tonight. He's going a little deeper early than he'd normally go, but what a good opportunity to get a bunch of younger players in the game and get them some experience.
That's exactly right. Smart move. So Bennett back into the game, replacing Barney. And Miller back into the game as well, replacing Blevins.
Rebound Slade.
You know, when you guys talk about these girls with the long hair,
you don't.
That's tough.
Pass in, fouled.
Fouls on Brittany Henry. Be her first. Ashley Adair to the line. Get your first.
It's a big free throw. Extends that lead to four.
They've been stuck on 10 for a while.
Yeah, it was 10-6 5 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Bennett to Miller. Bounce pass into Henry. Scoops it up. She's fouled by Timber Black.
Is this Monticello's first year for this head coach?
No, he's been there a
okay.
while. I'm not sure how many years Coach Craig Black has been there, but I remember him from the past few.
Okay.
Whether that's three or seven, I don't remember. Makes her second.
4-point game, 40 seconds left
Bobcat,
in the first half.
Yeah, Bobcats 4 of 5 from the foul line, and Monticello 6 of 6 from the foul line. Both teams shooting extremely well from the foul line. Hopefully we end up with the seniors up here. We're trying to get it set up, but not seeing them up here from Rich and
Tindick.
So. Rebound, 1 second. And that's going to do it. The first half ends. So we thought we were going to get a lot of points in that second quarter. We got 12. 8 in the first, 12 in the second. 12-8 lead for the Bucks. We'll take a break and come back. Hopefully we can get some of these seniors in the studio.
Come in and see Cocomotive Candy's new location on Main Street in Ridgefield. Browse their selection of mouth-watering handcrafted candy, fudge, caramel apples, and more. They specialize in custom orders for appreciation gifts, gift baskets, or any other special occasion. Call Cocomotive today.
All right, we're getting set up here. Mike's up in the studio. He's got the Tintic Miners with him. We're going to set it up to Mike.
Are we good, Dave?
All right, so I've got Bailey and Tina Wall with the Tintic Miners. Lady Miners, I guess, huh? Hey, thanks for coming in the studio with us. Congratulations on a great season. You guys were awesome to watch. We watched you for the last 4 years, come every year, and you guys work so hard. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. It's been fun. It's been a great 4 years. Basketball is my favorite sport, and I'm going to miss it so bad. I love everything about it. I just love competing, and I'm going to miss it like crazy.
That's a it's hard adjustment, huh? Bailey, what are your plans now? What are you going to do after what's your favorite subject? What are you going to do in
next?
What's okay. next?
I'm going to College of Southern Idaho. I'm going to go around cross country up for them. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
And what's your favorite subject? What are you going out in?
Oh, I'm going to go into nursing. I want to be a CRNA.
Awesome. Well, congratulations. Good luck with that. Cross country's I wasn't a cross country runner, you can see. Tina, how about you?
I plan on going to SUU and pursuing a career in criminal justice. I'm going to try and become an FBI agent, law enforcement.
Awesome, that's awesome. David's going nuts back there. SUU is one of our title sponsors. They sponsor these tournaments, and that's David. David's an alumni from there, so he's all excited. So FBI, that's awesome.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I really enjoy helping people, and it's been a great season for me, and I really love basketball, and I wouldn't be where I am today without it, so it's really been awesome. So.
Awesome. Well, thanks for coming and spending a minute.
Are you the ones that always do the commentary for all the games?
We are.
I love it. You guys do great. I love it.
Confused about us?
Well, like sisters, cousins, yeah. So tell everybody.
We're not related at all.
Not at all. Separate. Wow.
Commentary, it's great.
Awesome. Well, thanks.
When Sierra was here, you guys thought we were twins. I thought that was awesome. It was funny, but we're not. We're not even. Her and Sierra Wall are sisters, and I'm not. I'm an outcast.
Well, we won't say outcast, but all right. Well, we'll send it back down to Dave, and then we've got the Rich Rebels coming in next. So it's back to you, Dave.
Okay, guys. Doing
the worst.
Hey, thank
snap
you.
Snap out of it.
For the
become a new you in no time. With Logomaniacs, look your best. Logomaniacs, the right look for the right price.
Bryce Canyon sure is amazing, but don't just stand there at the overlook. Hop on the saddle for a true Wild West experience. Ruby's Inn has the perfect horseback adventure for your family. Whether it's just an hour and a half ride to the canyon rim or a full day getaway to the very trails used by outlaw Butch Cassidy, we've got rides for first timers and old timers. Come visit us in the lobby to plan your adventure or call 866-782-0002. Ruby's Inn, the wonder of the West.
Okay, we're back. Hey, we've got the Rich Rebel seniors in the studio with Mike, so we're gonna send it up to Mike. He's talking back there. I had to shut him off.
All righty, folks. Hey, welcome out to the studio. I have got the seniors minus one of the Rich Rebel basketball team. Just completed the season, finished in fifth place. That's a great finish this season. Congratulations, girls. David and I sit up here, we call all the games. We love watching your play. You work so hard. Congratulations on a hard-fought season. So I'm gonna just ask you, tell me your name, and then where you're going to college, what your plans are, just real quick.
I'm Millie Weston, and I'm headed to Utah State after graduation, majoring in communicative disorders.
I'm Michaela Davis, and I'm going to go to Utah State as well and major in education.
I'm Andy Cornea, and I'm going to Utah State too, but I don't know what I'm going to major in yet.
I'm Heather Thompson. I'm going to head to Utah Valley and major in journalism.
I'm Ashley Broll, and I'm going to go to Idaho State and be a physical therapist.
Had some people just walk through our studio. It's kind of impromptu here, but that's awesome. I'm so proud of you girls and your hard work. It takes a lot. What's something that just sticks out to you your senior year of basketball?
So we are really good friends on the team, and that's just something that has stuck out to me is as the season goes on, we just become better friends and get along, and it's been a lot of fun to be a part of.
Awesome.
I just love being here with all of these guys. We've grown up together playing basketball, so it's really fun to be here and be on a team together.
One thing our coach really emphasized this year was being tough, so I just learned how to overcome adversity, and I'm going to take that into my life and use it to overcome all the challenges that I face.
I got to echo Michaela on this one. I think our teamwork was really good this year.
I agree with Michaela and Heather. Teamwork was the number one goal, and that was what took it to a lot of wins this year, was getting the ball passed around and being patient and just working together.
Awesome. Well, thank you for taking a minute. Congratulations on a great season. Maybe that's not what you dreamt of the first year. Everybody dreams of a state title, but it takes a lot to finish in fifth place. I know. I've been there. Great job. Congratulations, and good luck in life, because this just propels you on into life. Your hard work there translates. So congratulations, and thanks again for spending a minute with us. Back to you, David.
Okay. Hey, Mike, thanks. Sure enjoy those interviews, don't you, Clint?
Yeah, that's awesome.
A lot of, you know, it's more about the game than the game. It's about, you know, these youth really excelling, doing well in life, and kind of fun to hear about what their plans are. Hey, we'll be right back. Actually, we'll keep it right here. We just want to thank our sponsors of tonight's game. Ruby's Inn, KTTA, SUU, Garcane Energy, Garfield County, the Bryce Half Marathon, Cocomotive, Logomaniacs, the Comfort Inn here in Richfield, RK Siret Video Services, State Bank of Southern Utah, Bryce, well, that's Garfield County again, South Central Communications, Henry's Drive In Out Coal, Bullseye Pest Control, Garfield Memorial Hospital, Joe Dalton Auto Body, Kenny Ray's, they're on Main Street in Panguitch, Panguitch City, Panguitch Drug, Rocky Mountain Fence, Royal Express Transmission, Security Title, Wilson Wenton, and Zions Bank.
Take a breath, Dave.
Breathe. Pass down to Miller. A lot of contact those last couple plays on both ends, and no call. That's a lot of fun seeing. You know, I know I heard you talking as I sat down, Dave. It's a lot of fun just getting that minute to just talk to those girls and see what their plans are. And they're, I wish I had, when I was their age, I wish I had as much figured out as they seem to.
Yeah. So I have to say, the FBI agent, though, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's a first.
That is a first. Tina Wall, Special Agent Wall.
Black with a great play, but blocked by Bennett. She's wanting a foul on that, but it looked pretty clean. Wow.
And there's been a couple down here. The last two times Black shot the ball, she's been hit pretty hard, it looked like.
I think the officiating is probably just okay to let him play at this point, which is okay to, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll leave it there.
Yeah.
Stands are filling up, getting ready for the championship game. Bennett. 18-footer left wing, got it.
And the Blevins girl is her.
Yeah. Basket good. Alyssa Reeve with the basket.
Bennett up top to Miller. Back to Torgerson. Into Birch.
Turns, looks, triple teamed. Atlanta Black steps in and just I'm going to take that ball.
Yep. I can tell you what I've noticed in state basketball is the fouls drop and the jump balls increase.
Yeah.
You notice that? I mean, it almost flip-flops from regular season, which is okay. Again, another jump ball.
Yeah, I think they just let them play, and so then consequently they get the jump instead of the foul, which allows the girls to play.
Yep.
Doesn't decide it. Armand in the corner, deep two.
Sixteen to ten here. Early in the third.
Ball tipped up in the air, picked up by Mon. Birch with the reach in.
Brittany Henry will replace Birch. She picks up her second foul.
Ball on the floor, pulled up. Black. Picked up by Torgerson. And she started to stand up, and as she picked that knee up, they called her for a travel.
Oh, I struggle with that one. Them travel calls, it's hard. You know, everybody has their own interpretation of it, which is okay, but pretty wild. Either way, Monticello ball back to Black up on top.
Reeve.
Nice move, but blocked by Bennett.
Black in
Adair.
To Adair.
Torgerson comes down with the rebound, clears it off up top to Orton. Back to Torgerson. Shantae Miller. Back to Bennett. Orton drives, goes up with it, gets it. Nice move.
Capri Orton, 3 points in the game. Leading scorer in the game has 4 points. And there's a couple of them on each team. Well, no, there's a couple of them on.
Adair travels, ball back to Panguitch.
Just too many turnovers by Monticello. They have the 4-point lead. Bobcats struggling to get anything going on offense.
You know, Mike, with Birch on the bench, though, she kind of runs this offense.
3-point basket by Henry.
It's kind of forcing these other girls to kind of do it. And so Henry figures she'd take her chance. Great shot.
A reach in by Torgerson. Birch has, is she in foul trouble?
So she only has 2 fouls.
Huh.
Air replaces Torgerson. That last foul was on Torgerson, just her first.
Oh, nice lob inside to Atlanta Black. Doesn't get it to go. Air with the rebound. Out to Orton. To Henry. 3-on-1. Burt Bennett pulls up. Rebound Henry. Up, no good. Henry again with the rebound.
Ooh.
And she fouled and pulled to the ground by Timber Black.
I think if you went down and asked them right now if this game meant anything, it was a little different than when the game started.
Yeah.
They've picked it up for sure.
Timeout on the floor. We'll be right back after this.
If you are headed to the state tournaments in Richfield, book your room at the Comfort Inn of Richfield today. Rooms are filling up fast. We offer clean, comfortable rooms with all the amenities to make your home away from home. Enjoy our free hot breakfast featuring eggs, meat, yogurt, fresh fruit, cereal, and more, including your choice of hot waffle flavors. To book your room today, call 435-893-0119 or book online at comfortinn.com/richfield.
If you want any of these tournament games on high-definition Blu-ray DVD, call Rod Syra Video Services. Also, if you have old family videos or old game film that is sitting around deteriorating, give Rod Syra a call. He can.
Hey folks, any of these games are available, and all of these games are available on high-definition Blu-ray from RK Syrup Video Service. No need to sit there and hand-hold your shaky. I've seen people trying to hold video with an iPad, and the video is probably fine, but just watch the game. You can buy the whole tournament for cheap enough price. Contact Rod, and then it's on high-definition Blu-ray. You enjoy the game, and there's no hassle. And you get to listen to us.
Yes, that's the best part. I mean, come on. We bought all of them from the last 3 years where I've had boys, and we've kind of missed the one a little bit. I know you guys have too, and it's been great to watch them videos and kind of bring you back.
Bannon again for a deep two. No, they're fun to have.
Yep.
Fun to have. So.
Great quality. Is that just a two-point basket by Bannon?
Yeah, it was.
Deep two.
Yep. Yeah, her last two buckets have been that 18 to 19 foot two pointers, 6 inches further out, and it's a three, you know. Blocked by Bennett. Blocked again by Bennett.
Miller pulls it down.
Orton on the break, across to Henry. Orton looks. Bobcats slow it down. Henry for three, that's short. Rebound, it's Reeve. Mon loses the handle. Picked up by Miller. Miller on the break, she'll take it all the way. Mon gets back, but Miller makes the basket.
Stretches Penguin's lead out to three. Lob pass into Black, just off the end of her fingers. Megan Black back into the game, replacing Reeve.
Timeout, Bobcats. We'll be back after this.
State Bank of Southern Utah has a variety of mortgage products to choose from, ranging from regular conventional mortgages with loan terms of 30, 20, 15, and 10-year terms to VA loans, FHA, 100% financing with USDA, and jumbo loans. State Bank offers free pre-qualifications, and you can schedule an appointment with one of our experienced loan officers to ask all your questions.
Seconds to go in the third period. The Bobcats with a three-point lead. Inside to Barney. Henry for three. That's her second three-point basket. 7 points in the game for Henry, Clint.
Yeah, she's knocking them down. She's played well in the third quarter here.
Ball on the floor, tied up.
Jump ball. We'll go to the Bobcats.
Timber Black went to the ground awkwardly. Yeah. She gets up okay, but the way she went down on her elbow, it looked like her head hit the ground. Bobcat basketball.
So Bobcats up six with the ball, Mike. It's kind of turned it around here.
Yeah, only 4 points scored again. 4-8-4 for the Mon.
Morton lose a handle on it.
Half court shot off the front of the rim. I thought we were going to see another one like we did last night. So after three quarters of play, 16-22, Bobcats. We'll be back after this.
Welcome to the playoffs. We wish you the best of luck at the tournament. At South Central Communications, our dedicated team is working overtime, bringing you the fastest, most reliable network available. I'd like you to meet some of our team.
We lay it down, splice it together, and deliver it to your property. We connect your home and business and guarantee you'll be running at top speed.
And we're making sure you're completely satisfied with every phase of the game.
SCC's dedicated team won't drop the ball. We're committed to providing with the fastest, most reliable network available. Call us today and get connected, or visit us online at socen.com.
When it comes to traditions, at the top of the list would be Henry's Drive-In on Highway 89 in Panguitch and a hot and juicy chubby cheeseburger. Julie and Colleen at Henry's wish all teams the best of luck.
All right, folks, welcome back. This Utah High School Sportscast. I'm Mike Alstrom. He's Clinton Brinkerhoff, and David Tebbs producing. Rod Syard on the camera. They're going to get Miller with a hold. I believe that was on Miller.
Yep. It's her third team foul. So we're a long ways from the bonuses here, Mike.
Yeah. You know, that's something, as they get closer, you almost want to think about and start getting a few, so if you need to get a foul.
Brittany Henry steals the inbounds play up quick to Birch.
Birch just double dribbled and nobody.
To air, just off the front of the rim. Rebound of the Monticello. Yeah, there was a little bit of a travel there, but.
That's through Black's hands out of bounds. Monticello just making too many mistakes. But it's still low. I mean, it's a six-point game.
Yeah. Birch back will start the fourth quarter for the Bobcats. She set most of the third.
I have Birch just making two free throws. She's her whole game, Clint, has been just that slash, that catch and drive in the paint.
Little pump fake.
And I haven't seen that tonight from her.
Air.
Oh, nice save by Air. Able to just tipped up in the air by Timberblack, and then Air gets a finger on it, knocks it to Birch.
Barney to Henry. In the corner to Air. Air drives. Kicks it back out to Birch. Thought about it and give it up.
You know, that's one thing the Bobcats are content running the clock.
Yeah. 6-point lead. They don't need to hurry at this point. As hard as offensive points have been to come by. Into Shantae Miller. Miller makes a move and goes up and she's fouled. Like it's on Adair. Actually, Timber Black.
Her third.
Yep. So Miller makes her first. Got it. So Panguitch extends their lead to 8 points. Just over 6 minutes left here.
Black, the ball's tipped, and Black didn't realize it. So tries to save it back in, and a foul on Birch.
their third. Taken away by air, but Black grabs it back. Drives in, goes up.
Loses the handle, ball pops up in the air. Miller on the break, will be hard to catch. Scoops it up and scores.
Monticello's in need of a bucket right here, Mike.
Yeah, they are. It's been a long time since they scored.
Into Megan Black.
In fact, I mean, they've only got 4 points in this whole second half.
Yeah. But the Bobcats play tenacious defense.
They do.
I mean, you got to give it to them.
I mean, they held the Mustangs to 28 points last night. They held Tindic to 31 points, and then they held Panguitch Duchesne to 15.
Yeah.
That's pretty amazing. 70 points allowed by the Bobcats in 3 games.
That's impressive.
You're going to win a lot of games if you can have a defensive showing like that. Offense, it's overrated, Clint.
I'm telling you, if you can't play defense in the state tournament, you're in trouble.
Lob inside the Slade, tipped away by Barney.
Good defensive play by Barney. To Henry, back to Birch. Over to Orton.
Air. The hair, I'm telling you. There's that hair covered up the zero. Miller cuts baseline, catches, shoots for two.
Miller, she's looking good here in the fourth quarter.
Baseline drive from the left wing, put back up, and Slade will be fouled.
Barney picks up her first foul. This is the first.
That is unlike the Buckaroos, Lady Bucks. They've been shooting really well from the free throw line. Baseline, Henry got another bucket. 9 points in the game for Henry. Henry with 9, Miller with 10 for the Bobcats. 13-point lead for the Bobcats. So we'll be back after this.
The Alton Coal Development is located in Alton, Utah. The development employs 32 people at the extraction site, and another 30 are employed driving trucks. Alton Coal reclaims the land by restoring habitat for sage grouse and cattle. Alton Coal, restoring habitat and creating jobs.
Bullseye Pest Control, specializing in bug, lawn, fruit tree, garden, and weed spraying, termite pre-treats, and free termite inspections. A beautiful lawn doesn't happen by itself. Now's the time to aerate your lawn, serving Garfield, Paiute, Sam Pete, and Wayne counties. Give Jeff a call, 435-313-2855.
Garfield Memorial Hospital serves the residents of Paiute and Garfield counties and is dedicated to providing quality, compassionate medical care. Garfield Memorial is ranked in the 97th percentile in patient satisfaction and in the 99th percentile for ER satisfaction. Nationally ranked care in a small community at Garfield Memorial Hospital in Panguitch. Go Region 20. From dents to scratches, auto service, paint, and detailing. Give Joe a call today for any of your auto body needs. Joe Dalton Auto Body in Circleville, 435-577-2442. Wishing Region 20 team success.
Off the timeout, it's Monticello basketball. Ball knocked away by Torgerson. Drive, pull up, shot, good. Adair.
Maybe we're saying it wrong, Mike.
No, we're not.
Okay.
But you're right. They do say Adair in a lot of places, but in Torgerson takes a shot to the
nose, it looks like.
Mouth.
She won't even look at her coach. She don't want to come out of the game.
She's like, don't take me out. Get over there. I'm fine. Tough girl.
Yep.
Right there on the end of the nose, that's a bad place to take a shot.
Miller cuts back, and they get it to her for two. Nice
Shantae
pass.
Shantae Miller with 12 points in the game for the Bobcats. Lana Black drives, double team, kicks to Mon. The Bobcats have held Atlanta Black to 4 points, Clint.
Wow.
Ashley Adair with four, Black with four, Alyssa Reeve with four, Allie Mon with four.
It is smothering defense. There's no doubt about it.
There's only been, the Bobcats have allowed 7 points in the second half. Adair makes another bucket. Adair. It's kind of like Houston or Houston. Depends on if you're in Panguitch or in Kanab. Taken away by Adair. 11-point game. Black to Mon. Fakes, drives, 10-footer. No good. Rebound to Atlanta Black. One dribble and fouled. Won't go. Makes them both, cuts the lead to 9.
Yes.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Henry with the rebound. Miller way ahead of the pack. Birch sees her. Miller lays it in. 14 points in the game for Miller. Pass taken away, fouled by Black. Atlanta Black's fourth foul. Just watch that replay. Oh, my goodness. So, was it Torgerson takes it out, hands it into Birch. Birch steps out and passes it back in.
Offensive foul called
on the
Torgerson.
Torgerson. That highlight will be uploaded to YouTube. You can say, here, I'll pass it in. No, you pass it in. Okay. Taken away.
Henry. So Penguin's defense just stepped it up a gear here, Mike, in the second half.
And now up to 11 points for the Buckaroos in the second half, but 23-34, low-scoring game. We expected that.
Yeah.
I
think we just scored 26 in the second half.
Yeah, no, they have.
So
And so substitutions for the Buckaroos. Five of them sitting there waiting to come in. Trying to think, see the numbers. Number 20 is Megan Black. Ball stripped, picked up by Mon. She steps on the line. So number 11 is Journey Baird.
22.
Number 22 is Erica Hill.
24.
I don't have a 24, sorry folks. Tristan Esplin is 5. Henry, baseline jumper, no good. Rebound out of bounds off the Bobcats.
Penguins with the timeout.
Coach Barney wants to get some subs into the game, so he calls a timeout to do so. So the Bobcats, I mean, 34-23 with 30 seconds to go. The Bobcats will win and take third place. I think it's safe to call it at this point.
I would think so.
And the Monticello Buckaroos will place fourth in state. Okay, we'll be right back.
From giant delicious fluffy pancakes for breakfast and our great selection of sandwiches for lunch, to our choice steaks or our amazing homemade country fried steak and mashed potatoes for dinner, top it off with homemade pie and Kenny Ray's is just like home. Go Region 20. As Utahns, we don't have to go far to find a bit of heaven. Historic Panguitch City, nestled in southern Utah's high plateaus, just 20 miles from Bryce Canyon National Park. Panguitch is a year-round celebration of heritage and outdoor culture. At the junction of Highway 89, Panguitch City wishes the Bobcats the best of luck. There's nothing quite like getting your prescription filled where the employees know you and you know them. We have the time to help you make informed decisions, personalization that a mail order pharmacy can't provide. At Panguitch Drug, we believe that friendly, fast service is most important. Thanks for supporting Panguitch Drug.
All right, for you, Pace Clark. I can't say it, Clint.
This is Mikey D and Bizzo coming at you live from the Sevier Valley Center.
Pace Clark texted that to Clint and said we should bring it in that way. So there you go, Pace. Remember, folks, stick around for the post-game report and highlights brought to you by Ruby's Inn. Bucket good.
22.
Number 22.
Erica Hill.
Hill. Was that number one?
No. She's not on the paper.
Oh, yeah, but she's on the floor.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, I thought it was.
Pass in, tipped away. That's going to do it. So the final 25-34 Bobcats win. Hey, folks, we'll be right back after Ruby's Inn for the Ruby's Inn postgame report and highlights after this.
Rocky Mountain Fencing, located in Panguitch, has been serving southern Utah for over 20 years. Owner Mark A. Engelstead is a proud supporter of Region 20. Give Mark A. a call today, 435-463-1659.
Royal Express Transmission, Stewart and his staff of highly trained technicians can take care of any of your automotive needs, brakes, inspections, alignment, transmission, ATV repair, and towing. Give Royal Express a call, 435-676-8300. From Stewart and RG and Ivy, go Region 20.
If you are buying or refinancing a home, did you know you can request your own title company? Keep business local and request Security Title for all your title, closing, and escrow needs. Travis and Hillary wish all team success in the postseason tournaments.
Having a beautiful, confident smile is something everyone deserves, which is why we're dedicated to providing our patients with an exceptional orthodontic experience. We want to give you a smile you'll be proud to share for the rest of your life. Give Wilson and Wetton a call, 435-586-8980. Zions Bank in Panguitch, Utah, your full-service bank for all your lending needs. Give Scott Campbell and his professional staff an opportunity to serve you. Wishing all of Region 20 success in the postseason tournaments.
Utah's Bryce Canyon is a landscape so intense, so mind-boggling that you gotta stand inside it, below it, and above it, just to take it all in. And the only way to be that close to world famous.
All right, Mike, we're back.
fourth time's a try, Dave. He sit there talking in my ear. Hey, folks, welcome back for the Ruby's Inn post-game report and highlights, brought to you by Ruby's Inn. Hosting visitors to Bryce Canyon National Park and the surrounding area for over 100 years. You just watched the third, fourth place game between the Panguitch Bobcats and the Monticello Buckaroos. Bobcats won 34-25. Monticello just could not get it going after the half. They scored 12 in the first half, 13 in the second. The Bobcats outscored them 26-13 in the second half. For the Bobcats, Capri Orton had 3 points, Brittany Henry with 9, 2 big 3-pointers, Brianna Birch with only 2 points. She spent a lot of time on the bench. I don't know if Coach Barney was just giving the younger girls a chance in the state tournament, which that's probably the case. Shantae Miller had 14 points for the Bobcats, led all scorers. Great game for Miller, a lot of those on breakaway lay-ins. And good passes ahead from their teammates. Jordan Bennett finished with 6 points. And for the Buckaroos, Timber Black with 2 points. Ashlyn Adair with 6. Atlanta Black with 6. Isabel Slade with 1. Alyssa Reeve with 4. Allie Mon with 4. And number 1 was not in the program. Sorry. She had 1 2-point basket. So go through the games of the day so far. Wayne County beat Milford to take sixth place. And so Milford finished in eighth. Rich beat Tindic. So Rich finished in fifth, Tindic in seventh, and Panguitch finished in third place, Monticello in fourth. We are all set, ready to go for the championship game. We've got something coming up, folks. We hope, we'll probably get to it in a little bit. We've got an interview with the cheerleader that has
Hannah Strebel
from Tabiona. She has Down syndrome. She participates in, she's a cheerleader. She's a basketball player. She's a volleyball player. She told her mom the other day she
drill
ordered
team.
Her track uniform.
Yes,
and she does drill
said.
Team. So Hannah Strebel, we have about 11 minutes with her and the seniors. They support her so well, and we've got that ready to go. We'll play that for you here in just a little bit.